Our patients come to us to be healthy. Part of the agreement we enter into with them is to first do no harm. Even hospitals that appear to be clean can have dangerous pathogens lurking in unexpected places. So how can we keep everyone safe? Today, let's follow three animals as they head to see their veterinarian. Brutus is coming in for a checkup. Grace has been missing the litter box and her owner's getting worried. And Samantha is coming in because she's been coughing and there have been reports of canine influenza in the area. In order to treat these pets and make sure that everyone stays healthy, we need to take the proper precautions. In the next few minutes, we'll learn the top five ways to decrease hospital-acquired infections so we can keep pets and people healthy. By far, the most effective way of keeping infectious agents out of the hospital is to not let them in. However, that's clearly not possible and certainly not the case for little Samantha. So we should always suspect that an infectious agent might be coming through the door. The best way to confirm our suspicions is to practice vigilant phone triage. This way, the pet can be carefully handled at the hospital to decrease the risk to other pets. So today, instead of coming through the waiting room, Samantha was brought through the back. Another important way of protecting our patients is by improving our own hand hygiene. Even though we do this every day, whether we use soap and water or hand sanitizer, these are the areas we tend to miss. So aside from realizing that and upping your game, here are simple ways to make hand hygiene even more effective. Hand sanitizer works best on dry hands. Be sure to rub between your fingers and over the front and back of your thumbs, whether you use soap or water or hand sanitizer. And after washing your hands, avoid recontaminating them by using a towel to turn off the faucet. If Samantha's team is going to treat her illness and keep their healthy patients safe, they need to make sure that their healing hands are truly clean. Just like hand hygiene, even though we clean our hospitals every day, doesn't mean we're doing it correctly. So we need to revisit how to clean and disinfect properly, because mistakes are often made. First, let's clarify the difference between cleaning and disinfecting. Cleaning is removing visible material like dirt, food, and feces using a detergent or soap and water. Disinfection is applying a chemical to kill microbes or bacteria and viruses. Most disinfectants work best after cleaning has removed the debris. This is why it's so important to do, but it's a step that's often forgotten. Also, the amount of time a disinfectant is left wet on a surface is important. That's called contact time. And most disinfectants have a contact time of 1 to 10 minutes. So even though we often feel rushed to clean a cage or an exam table, be sure to wait long enough for the disinfectant to do its job. Otherwise, infectious pets, like Sam, could leave behind nasty pathogens. Other tasks we must remember to do to stop the infection include using elbow grease to get rid of organic debris, removing the residue left over by a disinfectant by rinsing it with water after the appropriate contact time, clean objects that come in frequent contact with animals and people, protecting ourselves while doing laundry that could be contaminated with pathogens. We should also protect ourselves when we're handling potentially infectious patients by using personal protective equipment or PPE. Now, PPE all by itself is not magical. It requires proper donning and doffing to provide protection. Follow these steps for putting on PPE properly. Number one, perform hand hygiene. Number two, put on shoe covers. Number three, put on a gown. Number four, if needed, put on a mask. Number five, also if needed, put on eye protection. Number six, put on gloves. And when you're finished, to avoid contaminating your clothes, removing PPE properly is important. So follow these steps. Number one, remove shoe covers. Number two, remove the gown and gloves together. Number three, perform hand hygiene. Number four, remove eye protection. Number five, remove mask. And number six, perform hand hygiene again. Lastly, don't rely purely on PPE to protect yourself and your patients. Instead, if you are suspicious that an animal could be infectious, don't wait to isolate. When we're treating an animal in isolation, Be mindful to keep clipboards, pens, computers, and other medical equipment within the isolation room so they don't spread disease. Now, if we don't think isolation is required, but precautions should still be taken, be sure to document this and alert the staff. By incorporating these 5 ways to decrease hospital-acquired infection, we can make sure that pets like Brutus, Grace, and Sam, and all the other pets and people who enter our hospitals, go home healthy. Learn more about AAHA's infection control, prevention, and biosecurity guidelines and additional resources at aaha.org/biosecurity.